Good morning, Vandal. In the last session, we have seen that sampling and quantization. Let us have a brief look into it once again. We will try to go through Nyquist-Shannon sampling theorem. This is the process of sampling. In today's lecture, we are going to analyze that sampling in frequency domain. Frequency domain analysis of that entire sampling process. That thing we are going to do in today's session. Here, let's consider continuous time analog signal represented by XCRT. XCRT, C means continuous time. XCRT is the continuous time signal. And X of N is the discrete signal. It's a final discrete signal we are going to get, X of N. You see, open brackets is for continuous and these closed brackets are there, right? Closed brackets. That is for discrete case. X of small n. That is for discrete. Here, X of N equals to X of NT or X of NTS. Earlier, we followed the notation TS, right? TS is the sampling period. In this textbook, we are going to follow TS equals to T. Whatever the figures I am going to have in my PPT, all those figures corresponds to discrete time signal processing textbook by Oppenheim. This is that reference. They are going to follow capital T notation in place of TS, that sampling period. That's the only difference we are having. Yeah, what they are going to do is the mathematical representation of sampling process. Let me consider some X of T signal as follows. This is time versus X of T. This Y coordinate corresponds to X of T, X coordinate corresponds to time. And what we are going to do is, we are trying to multiply this signal. Yeah, it's better to have somewhere here only. This is time. In order to avoid confusion, I'm trying to write just in parallel to this. These are impulse sequences. And this will go like that. And this gap corresponds to capital T. Capital T or TS. Here TS equals to T, where TS corresponds to sampling period. This is just a mathematical representation of that sampling process. For that, we are going for impulse train or sequence of impulses. Let's assume that height of all of them is 1. Area under these impulses are 1. Unit area. Like 1 you can consider everyone. And let's assume that this is t equal to 0. And here also same time. This is time axis, right? T equal to 0. And this corresponds to T because this gap is T, right? And this should be 2T, uniform sampling we are doing, 3T and so on. Similarly, this side, this will be minus T. This will be minus T, minus 2T, minus 3T like this and so on. At every NT where N belongs to integers, positive or negative integer, we are having some impulse with unit area. Like that you can think. Yeah, what is the mathematical expression for this? Let me follow the same notations. Here the impulse train is represented by S of T notation. Can someone tell me what is the mathematical expression for this? This is S of T. S of T signal, impulse train. Okay, what is the mathematical expression for this part? How to reprint this? Is analog impulse. Yeah, what is that? One of you can answer.
Delta of t.
Okay, delta of t, right? That is delta of t. And what will be the second one?
Delta of t minus capital.
Yes, delta of t minus capital T, right? This is delta of t minus 2t, and this is delta of t minus 3t, and this side, this will be delta of t plus t.
So t minus right side.
Yeah, this is plus, right? This is delta of t minus of minus t. Then that will become like plus t. And delta of t plus 2t, delta of t plus 3t, and so on. It means this s of t can be represented as follows. Sigma, okay, instead of k, it's better to go for another notations. Minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, yeah, n will be fine, right? We are going to follow the same relation. Small n, n equals minus infinity plus infinity, delta of t minus nt or nts. This is the mathematical representation of this impulse train or impulse sequence. Suppose if I try to multiply x of t with delta of t, what is the output I am going to get? Okay, just for your convenience, I am going for this. Yeah, what will be this output? X of t into delta of t minus tau.
X of tau into del of t minus tau.
Yes, X of tau into delta of t minus tau, right? You are trying to sample this X of t signal at a time t. And this is that sample value is x of tau, right? Similarly, this one corresponds to x of
X
zero.
naught.
Yeah, because x of t minus zero, x naught into delta of t. Now, x of t into delta of t minus nt. What will be this one? X of nt into delta of t minus nt, right? X of nt into delta of t minus nt. What's happening here is, let me consider some x of t as follows. And if I try to multiply this with delta of t minus t, for example, then what I am going to get is x of t into delta of t minus t, where x of t corresponds to this one. This is my x of t, right? This value corresponds to x of t, value of x of t function at t equals to capital T. That's what we are having, right? That means we are going to get a sample at a time t equals to t of this x of t signal if you do this thing. And if you do this one, we are going to get sample at a time t equals to nt of that x of t signal. X of t signal sample at t equals to nt. That thing we are going to get, right? This one corresponds to that sample. That's what we are going to do. We are trying to represent this sampling process mathematically. That's what we are doing here. We are just replacing with mass. That thing only we had until now. Now, if I try to multiply this x of t with s of t, where s of t will be sigma n equals minus infinity to plus infinity delta of t minus nt or nts. Then what will be this one? I can take this inside, right? Inside this summation, because x of t is not depending upon index n. I can take this inside of this summation. There is no issue with that one. And what will be this into this? Delta of t minus nt, then this will become like sigma n x of nt into delta of t minus nt, right? This is sample of x of t at t equals to nt, the sample value, right? value of x of t at t goes to nt. Like that we can get. It means what we are going to get is, let's say this is my x of t. Sit time. And if I try to multiply with this impulse train, just for example, I just consider three samples here, three impulses. Let me call it like minus t, 0 and t, 2t, 3t, this side minus t, minus 2t, minus 3t and so on. And area under each of these impulses is 1. Now, if I try to, let me call it like 0, let me call it like minus t, let me call it like plus t. If I multiply this one with this, if I do multiplication of this and this, see my s of t, what I am going to get is, this corresponds to x of minus t into delta of t minus t plus t, right? Because this is delta of t plus t. Delta of t plus t into x of t corresponds to x of minus t into delta of t plus t. I am going to get this thing, right? This will be replicated here, this height. This corresponds to x of minus t. This height is x of minus t, this part x of minus t, and similarly this part corresponds to and so on this side, and this is delta of t into x of t corresponds to x of 0 into delta of 0, little bit small height than this one, right? I am going to get x of 0 here, see minus t, and this is 0. And if I do multiplication of this one with this, then I am going to get x of t into delta of t minus t. Little bit smaller height compared to that, right? Bit smaller. Then this will be x of t and so on. This is a sampled version I am going to get, right? The sampled version of this signal. I'm just multiplying this impulse train with my analog signal x of t, and the outcome I am going to get is sampled version of this one, sampled version of x of t signal. I am going to get sampled version of that one. This one is nothing but this, right? Sigma n equals minus infinity plus infinity x of nt into delta of t minus nt. I am able to represent this mathematically. Now your turn. Can you just tell me, okay, let me go back to the same notations. Yeah, the notation I am following for this one is x s of t. X s of t corresponds to sampled version of x e of t. Continuous signal x e of t into s of t is a sampled version we are going to get. Then can you just tell me what is the frequency domain representation of this one? You are multiplying in time domain. What's happening in the frequency domain? See, multiplication in time domain.
Convolution.
Yes, convolution in the frequency domain, right? Then we are going to have x e of f. Linear convolution with this is convolution s of f. Can someone tell me what is s of f?
One, if it's impulse.
Oh, no. Yeah, I will try to give this. This is a periodic signal. S of t, whatever we consider, that is a periodic signal. That is periodic with period t, right? Minus t, 0, plus t, minus 2t, minus 3t and so on. This side has 2t, 3t and so on. It's a periodic sequence of impulses. Like this we are having s of t. And we can find Fourier series for this, right? Can we find Fourier series for a periodic signal? We can find Fourier series expansion, right? Sigma k equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. Yes, what will be this one? Ak e power minus j 2 pi by t. Period of this one is t, right? Fundamental period of this one is t. E power minus j 2 pi by t. Into what will be this one? Is it okay? E power minus j 2 pi k by t into t. This is the Fourier series expansion. Now, if you try to find Fourier series coefficient for this one, we are going to get ak equals to. Can someone tell me what is ak? How to find ak? One by t. In this way you can find, right? Is it okay? S of t e power 2 pi by t into k. This is the fundamental frequency in radians per second into t. The fundamental frequency, this is kth harmonic dt. Yeah, then what will be this one? What is S of t from minus t by 2 to t by 2? This is minus t by 2. This is plus t by 2. What is s of t from minus t by 2 to t by 2?
One.
Oh, it's not 1. This is impulse, right? Minus t by 2 to t by 2. S of t is nothing but impulse at 0. That is simply equal to delta of t, right? That is simply equal to delta of t. It means I can try to write like this. 1 by t integral minus t by 2 to t by 2 delta of t e power, and this whole thing we can reproduce, right?
Sir,
Yeah.
we wrote the formula S of t, no sir. There we will get the sine plus, no sir.
Okay,
E power S of t is equal to summation k is
okay.
equal to
Yeah,
minus
that's
in
good. This
plus
is
in.
plus, that's fine.
Okay, sir.
That is plus. Yeah, we need to take conjugate of that, right? That's why you got minus here. Yeah, that's fine. It's good. Okay. If you do this one, then what is this multiplication? Delta of t into some x of t. That is x of 0 into delta of t, right? Replace t with 0 here. E power minus j0 is nothing but 1, right? Delta of t into this one is nothing but delta of t into e power minus j 2 pi by t into k into 0. Replace t with 0. Let's assume this like some x of t. X of t into delta of t, nothing but x of 0 into delta of t. And this thing we are going to get like 1. This into this, 1 into delta of t. Then what is area under this impulse, unit impulse? What is this area? See one, right? Area under unit impulse is one. I am taking integration. I am trying to cover this thing, right? Impulse integral minus t by 2 to t by 2 delta of t. Area under this impulse is one. This unit impulse 1 by t, right? It means finally I got Fourier series expansion for my signal as follows. This is my actual signal t minus n t, n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. Impulse train, this can be written as follows. N equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. An. Okay. To avoid confusion, let me follow same thing. And where AK equals to 1 by t for all k. Is there any problem if I replace k with n? Is it okay or any problem is there for you?
We followed N only, sir, in SS.
Okay, yeah, any issue with, no issue with this one, right? See,
Yes,
if I
sir.
replace this k with n, because I'm renaming this k, that's it. I'm just renaming k. I am replacing all k letters with n letters. That's what I am doing. I'm not changing the limits. I'm just changing the name of this letter. That's what I am doing. There's no issue with this, right? I can write like this one, where an equals to 1 by t. 1 by t sigma n e power j 2 pi by t n into t. Like this, we are going to get finally. Now I can find Fourier transform for this one. See, the Fourier transform for periodic signals can be found as follows. First, you can do Fourier transform. After that, first you can find Fourier series for that periodic signal. After that, you can do Fourier transform. In that way, you can find Fourier transform for periodic signals. What is the Fourier transform for this? This thing. Yeah, what is the Fourier transform for this one? E power j 2 pi by t. It's impulse, right? Do you agree? Is it impulse? Delta of f minus k by t. See, otherwise you might heard about this just for your familiarity. But here we are trying to follow capital omega notation for our course. Yeah, what is the Fourier transform for this that we have studied? You might have studied this one. Delta of omega minus omega naught. But in our course, these are capital letters. Capital omega. Otherwise, you might have studied like f minus f naught. If omega naught equals to 2 pi f naught, where f naught is in hedges, that can be written like this. I am doing the same thing. F minus k by t. K by t is the frequency of this, right? 2 pi f naught t, where f naught equals to k by t here. Like that you can imagine. F minus k by t. That's what we are having. Yeah, what is 1 by t according to you? We are following some notation, right? What is 1 by t is? Ts is sampling period. Then what is 1 by ts called as?
Fundamental time period, sir.
No, no. According to our notations, previous notations. If I call ts like a sampling period, then 1 by ts is nothing but sampling rate, right? Fs is a sampling rate. That's fine. Fundamental period, that's okay. But if you try to map to our sampling theory notations, so 1 by ts corresponds to sampling rate, fs. It means this will be delta of f minus k times fs, right? Delta of f minus k fs. Now, what will be my Fourier transform s of f? 1 by t sigma n delta of f minus n fs, right? N equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. This is my Fourier transform for this impulse train. Now, I'll try to substitute into this expression. We have seen this, right? X is of f. Sampled version of my continuous time signal is x is of t. If I do Fourier transform for that one, convolution of x e of f and s of f. Let's assume that, yeah, let's assume that this is my x of f, x e of f, Fourier transform for my continuous time signal. Just for example purpose, I am considering this. Let me consider this one like f max and this one like minus f max. Yeah, what is the meaning of f max? You can have a look into this and answer me. Yeah, can you try once? Why I have written that like f max? It's a maximum frequency of the message signal. Like that you can think. This is my continuous time message signal. XC of T is my continuous time or analog message signal. And if I do Fourier transform for this one, this what I am going to get my spectrum. Just for my understanding, I have done some spectrum like this. And the maximum frequency in this spectrum, maximum non-zero frequency in this spectrum is F max, right? Is a maximum frequency in this baseband signal. Is it baseband signal? This is baseband signal. Baseband signal means that should have frequency components, all frequency components nearby zero, surrounding to zero. This is baseband signal. Somewhere nearby zero, we are having frequency components, right? Surrounding to this one. It's a baseband signal. Band pass signal means this is one kind of band pass signal. Yeah, let me go with same notations. Same, yeah. This will be one of my band pass signal. This is my carrier frequency, some FC or minus FC. If you map to your analog communications course, this corresponds to band pass signal. This is my baseband signal. I can call it like passband signal. Okay, that's fine. Band pass signal. This is my baseband signal. And band limited to F max. Yeah, these are just some notations. Band limited to, forget about this down part. Band limited to F max. Band limited to F max means here we are having F less than or equals to F max in our signal. The component that we are having is F less than or equals to F max. Baseband signal band limited to F max, less than or equals to F max. Now, okay, let me recall that XS of T equals to XC of T into S of T implies XS of F equal to linear convolution of these two things, S of F. You see, XC of F linear convolution with, yeah, what is this one? Can someone answer what we got? 1 by T. Yeah, what is this?
Del of F minus F.
F minus NFS, right? Where FS equals to 1 by T or 1 by TS? FS equals to 1 by T or 1 by TS. Because we are calling TS as T, right? It's a sampling frequency or sampling rate, FS. TS is a sampling period. Now, if we do convolution of this one with this, what we are going to get? XC of F convolution with delta of F minus NFS. What will be that? This is just a shifting operation, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what will be this? XC of F minus NFS.
NFS.
Yeah. You might heard about this, right? X of T convolution with delta of T minus T naught is nothing but X of T minus T naught, right? The same thing we are applying here. Convolution of this one with this one is XC of F minus NFS. It means this spectrum is repeating for every FS interval, right? For every FS interval. N equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And this side, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, up to minus infinity, right? Both sides that is going. And this is my XC of F, I am considering 0 minus F max. If that is real signal, by default, you are going to get frequency this side also, right? That magnitude spectrum is even symmetric and phase spectrum is odd symmetric by default when that is a real signal XC of T. That's why by default this will be there. is negative part, at least mathematically. Forget about practicality. F max and minus f max. See my x of f, and I want to do convolution with that s of f. Then I am going to get 1 by t sigma n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x c of f minus n f s. That's what I am getting. I'll try to draw this once. This is my x s of f, that span sampled signal spectrum. Suppose if I substitute n equal to 0, then what will be this one? N equal to 0. Xc of f, right? 1 by t into xc of f. You see, n is for all integers, minus infinity to plus infinity, all integers, right? If I have n equal to 0, at n equal to 0, I am having this one. 1 by t xc of f. Xc of f is nothing but this one, minus f max to plus f max. Plus f max, and if this is 1, height is 1, then what should be this height? You can have a look into this. 1 by 2, 1 by t into x e of f, right? 1 by t into 1, this will be 1 by t. Then what will be this for n equal to 1? See, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on infinity, and n equals to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on, minus infinity. What is this for n equal to 1? Yeah, you can interact. Okay, what is this for n equal to 1? 1 by t into
1 by t xc, yeah. Xc of f minus fs.
Yes, 1 by t into xc of f minus fs, right? Shifting this spectrum right side by fs. Xc of f minus fs means shifting this entire graph right side by fs, right? If I try to shift this right side by fs, then I am going to get like this. For some fs, for some large fs, if my fs is somewhat large enough, then what is this? And this will be 1 by t. Multiplying with 1 by t, after that shifting right side by fs. 0 will be shifted to, 0 will be shifted to fs. Then what happens to f max? Shifting right side by fs, right? It means plus fs we are doing. 0 plus fs is fs. F max plus fs.
Fs plus f max.
Yes, fs plus f max, right? And what will be this one?
Fs minus f max.
Yes, fs minus f max, right? And similarly, for n equals to 2, we are going to get 1 by t xc of f minus 2 fs. This will be shifted right side by 2 fs, this entire graph. It means 0 will be shifted to 2 fs, and f max will be shifted to 2 fs plus f max. This will be shifted to 2 fs minus f max. This will be 2 fs minus f max, and so on, 1 by t. Similarly, this side also, right? For n equal to minus 1, this will be xc of f plus fs. F plus fs means shifted left side by fs units. Left side shifting by fs units. This will become like minus fs. 0 shifted to fs, minus fs. And this will become like minus fs plus f max. This will become like minus fs minus f max. And so on. This is minus 2 fs, minus 2 fs minus f max. Minus 2fs plus f max, minus 2fs minus f max, and so on, this side and this side. Like this we are going to get. That's what we got finally. In this case, what condition we satisfied here? Fs greater than 2fm. Yeah, I am writing two statements. You need to figure out which one we are satisfying here, which one is true. Just have a look into this and answer. See, no need to look into this entire plot. Just have a look into this plot and answer.
Fs greater than 2 fm.
Here, Fs greater than 2 fm, right? Yeah, how you are able to say that one? Because the reason is this one. What is this? Okay, what is this frequency? Fs minus f max, right? This frequency corresponds to fs minus f max. What is this frequency? This is f max, right? You can have a look into this. This is f max. You can see this frequency is above this frequency, right? Fs minus f max above f max in this particular example implies fs greater than 2 times f max. This is the case where fs greater than 2 f max. Suppose I want to reconstruct my signal. How do you reconstruct that one? See, my question is this one. Where is that sampled one? Yeah, what my question is, x of t got multiplied with s of t, but x of t is a continuous signal. X of t is a continuous time signal multiplied with impulse train. Then we got this one. This is the sampled version, x s of t. From this, how can I reconstruct my actual analog signal? I want to get back to my x of t once again. Yeah, what to do? What I can do? Okay, I'll ask you a question. X of t, see what we have done there is we converted into samples x of nts into like that, right? Delta of t minus nts. This what we had done there. Okay, someone answered, I think. We have done this, converted to x of t. I want to get back to my actual x of t once again. And what is the procedure behind this?
Okay. By using inverse system?
No, I'll try to give you a hint. You can have a look into this. This is x of t, right? This is x of t, continuous, right? X of t. I want to get back to my x of t once again. X of f converted to, in frequency domain, x of f converted to 1 by t sigma n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x of f minus nfs. See, if I want, I can write equivalently as follows to avoid some confusions. 1 by t x of f plus sigma n equals to 1 to infinity x of f minus, okay, f minus nfs plus sigma n equals to minus infinity to minus 1 x of f minus nfs. I'm just separating into three parts. Now, yeah, this is a hint given to you. From this spectrum, I want to get back to my x of f. How to get back to x of f? You may be unable to think in time domain. At least you can try to think in frequency domain. I want to remove all these things, right? My target is I want to remove I want to filter all these components, then I am going to get 1 by t times x e of t. Do you agree this? In frequency domain, what I am planning is I want to remove all these components. I want to filter out. I want to have stop band in these frequency bands, and I want to have pass band in this band, in this band of frequency up to f max. Then I will get 1 by t into x e of f, and if I do some amplification kind of thing, I am going to get x e of f t into this thing. That's what my plan. Once I got x e of f in time domain, that is nothing but x e of t, right? In time domain, this is nothing but x e of t. That means I can get the help of filter. Now you can answer, what kind of filter I can use here? I want to remove all the things. I want to remove all the things, and I want to remove all the things. What kind of filter I can use? Can you have a look into this and answer?
Band pass, sir.
No, this is not band pass. This is low pass. See, don't think this like band pass. This is low pass. See, don't think about negative frequencies. It is just a mathematical purpose. If I draw some filter like this, that is a low pass filter. It's not band pass. You should not consider this part practically. It's a mathematical understanding purpose. This is 0 hertz, right? This is 0 hertz signal, and this is f max. I need a low pass filter from 0 to f max. Is it okay? Is there any issue with this one? For example, I can go for ideal. It's a hypothetical. Ideal means it won't exist practically. Ideal low pass filter with a cutoff frequency. What can be my cutoff frequency here? Fc.
F max.
See, do we have anything in between f max to fs minus f max? This is fs minus f max. Do we have anything between this and this? There is no signal at all, right? Is there any problem if I have my cutoff frequency up to this? Is there any issue with this?
No, sir.
Is there any issue if I have cutoff frequency like this? There is no issue, right? Within this band gap, I can have cutoff frequency anywhere, right? I can have my cutoff frequency anywhere if that is ideal low pass filter. It means my fc can be anywhere between f max to fs minus f max. Fc, cutoff frequency of low pass filter cutoff frequency, or this is what we call as analog reconstruction filter. Analog reconstruction filter means we are trying to reconvert those samples back to analog signals. Fc should be anywhere between f max and, okay, this should be fs minus f max. And this is the case. What is that case? What is the case that we considered? We consider this case, right? Fs greater than 2f max. When this is bigger compared to this one, fs minus f max greater than f max, then we are going to get fs greater than 2f max. In this particular case, we can do as follows. If you want to reconstruct my analog signal, I can simply pass that sampled signal through analog low pass filter with a cutoff frequency fc, where that fc can be anywhere between f max and fs minus f max, right? That's what I can plan. Okay, now I'll ask a question. Okay, which one you feel good? This is one thing. Okay, and so on. This side also. Let me consider this like 0. This is minus f max. Fm I am writing for max. This is fm. And this is fs. And this one is nothing but fs minus fm. This is fs plus fm. And so on. You can think like that. And into 1 by t factor is there. Into 1 by t is there. 1 by t is there. 1 by t is there. Like that. Now, can I? Yeah, what is the condition here? Do we have f minus fm greater than fm here? Are equal?
Equal, sir.
Here we consider equal, right? If I consider equal, it means fs equals to 2fm I consider. Now, if I have ideal filter with me, can I get back to my signal once again?
Yes, sir.
I can get back to my signal, right? If I have ideal filter, low pass filter, with a cutoff frequency fm. Ideal low pass filter, but that should be ideal low pass filter. If I have ideal low pass filter with a cutoff frequency f max, then I can get back to my actual analog signal from this one. There is no issue. But assume that, see, ideal low pass filter will never exist, right? The reason for that one is ideal low pass filters are not causal systems. They are not causal systems. You see, ideal low pass filter, practical filters will be like this. You see, ideal. In practice, you are going to have filters like this. There will be some transition band. Suddenly that won't drop to zero gain in the stop band. There is some transition band like this. It's a practical filter. Now, with the help of practical filters, is it possible to, with the help of practical filters, is it possible to remove this one?
No, sir.
You are going to get something like this. These are the practical filters. Along with your signal components, some unnecessary components also you are getting, right? You are also getting into your signal. That might behave like some sort of noise or disturbance to your signal XCRP, right? Corrupted signal you are going to get. In order to avoid this one, can you suggest me one way how to avoid this? I want to go with practical filters. I don't want to go for ideal filter. Ideal filter, it won't exist at all. No need to worry about that. That won't exist at all, ideal filter. Then if I go with high sampling rate, is it good? Is it okay for you? I will increase my sampling rate. Let me go further like this. This is my zero, f max minus f max. This is fs. This is fs minus f max, fs plus f max, and this side also you can imagine. This is ideal filter, but ideal filter won't exist. I am going for practical filter. Now, is it okay for you?
Yes, sir.
It's okay, right? Because nothing is there in between. There are no other components here. Even if you have some gain there, you won't get any disturbance, right? Earlier, we have some frequency components here. You can have a look into this. Earlier, we have some frequency components here in this transition band also. So that will cause disturbance for your reconstructed signal. Now, what you are having here is, there are no frequency components in between, right? Even if you are having some reasonable gain here, that won't affect you much, right? Because no signal is coming through this band of frequencies. Nothing is there, right? With the help of practical filters, you can do this one. But what is the condition we are considering here? Fs greater than, right? This is not equal. If Fs equals to Fmax, you require ideal filter. Suppose if I decrease my FS somehow, if I try to decrease my FS, then I may get my second spectrum somewhere here. If I decreasing FS, this is with some FS. If I decrease my FS, then is it causing disturbance to you? Yeah, you can answer.
So,
now
it's, sir, some noise get added.
Yeah, some noise gets added, right? It means you need to design your FS sampling rate in such a manner that if you apply this practical N-log reconstruction filter, that should not take this noise into that one, right? In such a manner, you can plan this FS. If this is your practical reconstruction filter with you, you can try to plan FS in such a manner that this is above this one. Like that, you can plan. In that manner, you can think. This intuitive understanding of that one. It means it's better to have FS to be somewhat high. That's required, right? Just maintaining FS greater than R equals to 2 F max may not be enough in practical scenario. You need to maintain that FS to be more than 2 F max. Just more than 2 F max also not enough. You need to maintain some reasonable gap so that you can reconstruct that properly, right? The help of practical filters with you. Okay, that is fine. Suppose if FS less than 2 F max, then what happens? Okay, let me have this. This is 0. This is F max. This is minus F max. And this is 1 by T. Now, we need to shift this right side by FS units, right? Shift this spectrum right side by FS. This is FS. Then what is this? FS minus F max, right? And this is FS plus F max. Yeah, by default, you can write both sides. In this case, FS less than 2 F max. This corresponds to FS minus F max, less than F max. You can see F max is above this, right? It's increasing frequency, this side. F max is bigger than FS minus F max. This side we are having, right? Right side. If this is the case, this is less than this one, implies FS less than 2 F max in this case, in this example. Then what's happening here? This is what we call it as aliasing. In the last class, you might have seen that in time domain, right? Frequency domain, you can imagine like this. Aliasing effect. Is it possible to construct your signal with the help of ideal filters also?
No, sir.
Ideal filters also, they can't do the task right in this scenario. This ideal filter with a cutoff frequency F max. Because my signal frequency band is up to F max, I want to apply an ideal filter with cutoff frequency F max. Ideal filter itself is impractical. Let's assume that ideal filter exists, just for namesake. And if you apply ideal filter, then also you are getting some disturbance, right? It's a disturbance you are going to get due to aliasing effect. High frequencies are behaving like low frequency components due to this undersampling. That's what we are getting. That's called as aliasing effect. It means you need to make sure that FS to be more than 2 times highest frequency of your baseband message signal in order to reconstruct back to your actual signal XCRP. This is required, right? You need to maintain this condition. Just equal to F max is not enough because you require ideal filters, right? You need to maintain something above 2 F max. Just above 2 F max also not enough. You can have, yeah, intuition from here. You need some reasonable gap, right? Above 2 F max plus something, some extra thing you require. This extra thing. It depends on your practical filter that you are having. See, if you go for very higher order filter, Thyroid filter means those filters are costly. The cost of the circuit is high. In that case, you may have small transition band, but definitely you won't have like ideal filter. You may have small transition band. Then this gap can be reduced. Your sampling rate need not be so high. You can decrease this to up to this level sampling rate in such scenarios. Based on your transition band, your filter should be high quality. High quality filter means cost also high and area required for design also high. Yeah, just try to remember up to this one. We'll try to formalize this statement in our next session. Yeah, thank you. Do you have any doubts?